Hi, welcome to QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB tutorial number 13. In this tutorial, we will simulate a simple flow past the standard NACA0012 airfoil using a simple turbulence model. This tutorial consists of roughly 5 steps. First of all, we will have to read the mesh and generate the boundary layer. Since it is necessary for running proper aerodynamic simulations. Next, we will properly initialize the solution and also set extra parameters for convergence, such as under-relaxation factors. After that, we will just solve the system as standard. Once the simulations are done, we will visualize the pressure coefficient and also compute aerodynamic forces and coefficients. Okay, so let's go. First of all, standard thing that is reading the mesh file. The mesh file is provided together with the tutorial that you can download from our website. The crucial thing, as I already said, is the generation of boundary layers. You use the structure that's called layers. A few parameters need to be set up, namely the height of the first element, the ratio of consecutive elements' height, and the number of elements in the boundary layer. Wall ID numbers also have to be specified. Here is only ID number 9. And finally, we need to regenerate our mesh by using function extrude layers. Then just update mesh to the second order and visualize the mesh. So let's execute the script. You can already see that the mesh is visible. Let's have a closer look at the boundary layer, how it was created. Yeah, let's look at the node section. Well, yeah, you can see maybe that's not the finest mesh, but it should be fair enough for performing a simple simulation. Okay, let's see how it looks further downstream. Yeah, you can see a few layers of the boundary layer present, and each one is thicker than the previous one. Okay, let's continue. Let's just set fluid viscosity. It will be air, so it's like 1.5 10 to the minus 5th. Okay, let's initialize our solution. We do it in a standard way. Use the function init solution. Use zero velocities and pressures as the starter. We will also create a copy of the velocity pressure field because it will be used in the under relaxation process. Maximum level of residuals will be 10 to minus 6 and maximum number of iterations, let's say, it should be 100. We'll also need the relaxation factor and let's give it try 0.6. Another necessary thing in the turbulent flow simulations is the computation of wall distance. We will store the distances of cell centers to the airfoil walls in the variable d. We'll get them using inbuilt function compute wall distance. Wall IDs are number 9. Now we will just need to define the value and direction of the inlet velocity. That's pretty simple. 0.75 meters per second will give us Reynolds number equal to 50,000. We specify the angle of attack to be 5 degrees, to recalculate it into radians, and also get proper complements of inlet velocity. Okay, we just check that everything is fine, just executing our script. Yep, so far so good. And now we set up the main iterative loop. I will give it as is and then discuss the details. Okay, so we iterate from 1 to max number of iterations. A few things should be already pretty well known to you. We assemble Navier-Stokes matrix, get N, S, and F. We impose boundary conditions at the inlet at the wall, compute residuals, and plot the residuals. The crucial difference in here is that we include the turbulence model. The turbulence model actually only affects the turbulent viscosity that we call as a parameter nu t, and it's an addition to standard viscosity in the standard Navier-Stokes formulation. We'll be using CITM Turbulence model. Basically, it's a hybrid of two models. If you want to learn more details about it, just check out our manual, Turbulent Viscosity. You will notice that CITM is constant intensity, just hybrid of van Driest, and velocity length model. Another comment is in place. I mentioned that we will be using relaxation factor. That means that before we assemble Navier-Stokes matrix in the next iteration step, we combine the previous solution with the yet one step back that was saved at US before we will solve in the system. That will help increase the convergence quality. Okay, now let's solve the system. You can observe how it starts converging. Great, the calculations are finished. The solution has converged. Let's move to visualizing the solutions. Okay, actually, before we have a look at the pressure coefficient, let's have a look at velocity. Just establish yet another figure and execute the piece of code. That's the solution display solution to dx velocity. Let's look how it looks close to the profile. Yeah, there's some sort of wake behind the profile. Let's have a closer look just at the leading edge. Yeah, so we can see stagnation point a little bit below the main line, because obviously it's a positive angle of attack. Yeah, and you can also watch how the boundary layer develops along the profile. Yeah, so it starts growing as it should be, and there it goes. Okay, now we will move to calculating the pressure coefficient in the whole domain. First of all, since pressure is stored only on the first order nodes, we need to interpolate pressure data to neighboring nodes using pressure generate pressure data in the domain. Yeah, there we go with the new field. Furthermore, we will need to find the maximum value of pressure, which is obviously the stagnation pressure that appears somewhere on the airfoil. In order not to check for the maximum in the flow domain, we will just extract the indices of the nodes that lie on the airfoil and look for the maximum over there. We use function extract nodes ID on edges, we give the node edge wall number, and then we look for the maximum over there. Let's evaluate this formula, and we can see that there's a value of Pmax which is larger than average zero pressure. Okay, furthermore, we need to define the coefficient. What we do is simply calculate the ratio of local pressure minus the maximum pressure plus a half of V infinity squared divided by half of V infinity squared. Please remember that density is not included in our pressure, therefore it doesn't appear here nor here. Finally, we can set up the plot. So we need to establish yet another figure and display the whole solution. Let's go. Yep, here comes the plot. Let's have a closer look on that. And exactly, pressure coefficient equal to 1 is in the stagnation point just below the leading edge of the airfoil. And the lowest pressure occurs just on the upper part of the airfoil in the dead zone. The last step for today is to calculate the forces and force coefficients that are on the profile. There is a built-in function into the toolbox that's called compute force that would integrate the loads on specified wall. Here we specified by number 9. The resulting force obviously is given in XY reference frame, horizontal and vertical. But we want to get the drag and lift, therefore we need to rotate this result in the direction that's oriented with the flow. We use just rotation matrix of sines and cosines. And we can execute the code to have a look at our results. Obviously, the sheer values of forces are little use when we want to compare different profiles. We need to get the non-dimensional coefficients simply by dividing lift and drag by half of velocity squared. So the last step for today is to evaluate CD and CL. Especially CL is close to experimental value, while CD is a little bit more complex, therefore it might a little bit depart from the data that is given in the literature. Anyway, that's all that we wanted to present you in this tutorial. We hope that you enjoyed.